Destiny is Bungie's first new IP since their success with the Halo franchise. It is the first part in a decade-long project to bring an MMO-like experience to the consoles. In doing so, they've crafted quite the oddity.
Destiny is a game combining elements from many genres with varying degrees of success. It is a multiplayer-focused first-person shooter supported by RPG mechanics and centered around a loot-based treadmill. Player will find a mission, explore an area, maybe kill a boss, and bring home the spoils of war before setting about on another mission.
It's a proven formula for addiction, and Destiny shows no mercy in getting its hooks into people.
The overall mechanics of the game are polished to borderline perfection. Shooting guns is satisfying, and picking up loot is rewarding. Where Destiny goes wrong, however, is in its content. Hailing from an MMO train of thought, the majority of Destiny's missions are repetitive and designed solely to level the player up for the post-game content. This mindset seems to have forced the game's plot to the back seat. From what I understand of it, the story revolves around the forces of light and their battle against the overwhelming forces of darkness. It's gripping stuff that I can honestly say the likes of which I've never seen before. The story is written and presented in a way to be intentionally confusing for the purpose of inspiring curiosity in the player. It's Bungie's hope players will be intrigued and wish to discover more, which they facilitate through awarding unlockable grimoire cards detailing the backstory of the Destiny universe.
Where they stumbled here, though, is by not providing an in-game mechanism to view these cards. To see them, you have to go to Bungie's website or the Destiny mobile app. This is simply unacceptable. The plot is a mess, and any needed context for the story is hidden away in these cards that aren't even important enough to be in the game. They're not important enough for me to seek out.
The multitude of mistakes with the story reduce it to mere background noise. With phoned-in voice acting as the final blow, it becomes clear the majority of it should be ignored for a more pleasant experience. Unfortunately, without a narrative to support it, the otherwise excellent gameplay eventually becomes hollow. As I pass level 20, a few key words entered in my head.
What am I fighting for?
Then, I passed in level 21 and realized I had not beaten Destiny. Destiny had beaten me. I'd fallen into the trap of grinding through missions dreaming of a legendary or exotic armor drop. The gameplay, while void of purpose, feels rewarding in spite of repetition. Every mission is a linear corridor full of the same three enemy types over and over. Even the boss fights are just regular enemies made gigantic. Yet, the shootouts are entertaining, and even more so if I can get three strange coins from the ordeal. This is partially thanks to fantastic AI and enemy design. Combatants always provide a competent and balanced challenge to the player's crusade through their territory, while still providing the player with the idea of being super powerful. A phenomenal presentation doesn't hurt either. Every planet is gorgeous in unique ways, assisted by a good soundtrack and overall sound design. This makes going through these environments satisfying on their own, even if it is for the 20th time.
Furthermore, Destiny is a game best enjoyed with a good group of friends. Bungie beats you of this concept repeatedly. In fact, the majority of late-game missions don't have any matchmaking support. The forced cooperation method might make sense, maybe those missions are really difficult, but what it does is it leaves a lot of people left out. Imagine if your friends don't own the same console as you, and maybe they have jobs and aren't on call to play at every second of every day. And what this does is it locks a lot of people out of a lot of the content they paid for.
You can hypothetically party up with strangers you meet in a designated social hub, but anonymous internet strangers are rarely so kind. Then, when you finally find strangers willing to help you, you discover the supposedly glorious endgame content is just the previous story missions at higher difficulty and higher loot drop percentages. Disappointing.
This series of tragedies might upset you. It might make you give up on the idea of cooperating with anyone for anything, ever. But luckily for you, there's regular first-person shooter multiplayer.
Destiny supports the expected shooter game types, including free-for-all, team deathmatch, and control points. In these modes, you'll find players tend to take a liking towards using one-hit-kill weapons, and why wouldn't they? So these game types are filled with a lot of seemingly cheap deaths and unsatisfying triumphs. The neat thing with the competitive multiplayer is that it uses your regular game's character and drops loot like a regular story mission. With all level advantages being disabled, this makes competitive multiplayer a good place to grind for items and experience. Other than that, it's just standard FPS nonsense.
And while I really am enjoying the game, there's still one more outstanding criticism I'd like to point out. A lot of critics missed it, and I wonder why. But Destiny is hiding a very deep and sinister secret. I'm afraid I'm gonna have to issue my very first Red Alert! If forcing people to cooperate with each other wasn't enough to make you sick to your stomach, then maybe these subtle clues will. Destiny's online competitive multiplayer is called The Crucible, an allusion to a play bashing the righteous people of Salem and attempting to discredit American hero Joseph McCarthy. Furthermore, in The Crucible, you earn a currency, and what's that currency called? Marks. Now I know Bungie made no hints as to the true nature of their game, so I forgive everyone who bought it. But if you continue to play the game after I just revealed the truth to you, well, I'd say God have mercy on your soul, but we both know that's not gonna happen, don't we?